Moving out from the world of textiles, moving more generally to the world of other stuff, non-textile stuff, we have the following hypothetical, where you have plastic pellets imported from France into the United States. And those plastic pellets are available under HTSUS 39, 3902, 10. In the United States, they're grinded, but their tariff classification remains the same. So the question is there a country of origin change? Is there a shift? So for this one, because this is a general non-textile product, we have to look at the different section, and that section is 10220. And we go to 390220 as our guide. So we scroll through or flip through. At the exam, you are going to have to flip through to chapter 39. All right, so chapter 39, 3902 falls somewhere in between this particular headings. So this rule is applicable to the question at issue. So the question goes like this: a change to heading 3901 through 3915 from any other heading, including another heading within that group, except a change 3907 from polyether of this subheading, provided that domestic polymer content is not less than 40% by weight. All right. So we have a you just have to change. But in here, there is no change. The grinding did not change the fact that it is classified and that it's classified under 390210. It was brought under 390210, and after grinding, it remained classified as 390210. So, we're dealing with marking. For marking purposes, this did not change the product. So as we can see over here in this in the next exam question here, we have the hypothetical that we the facts of which we very closely just discussed. A plastic milling plant located in New York City imports French pellets. This is the classification for grinding into the powder. The powder is made solely from foreign material, from the French stuff. The company claims the goods have been substantially transformed. Yeah, substantial transformation would be the key, but the key question here is there an after transformation? Notice how customs examiners ask you about this stuff. They do not specify NAFTA marking, right? They just give you the United States, implying that this is a NAFTA member, because United States, Canada, and Mexico are the NAFTA members, right? So we're looking for the correct statement: no change in tariff classification has been taking place. So let's take a look at the answer choices. All right, so the term country of origin always means the country of exportation. No. Country of origin is the country where there has been substantial transformation, unless there is other requirements, such as an after requirement of tariff shift. So no, that's not true. Country of exportation is actually, there is a separate box for the country of exportation on the declaration form. So that statement just cannot be true. Next, any further work added to an article in another country is always enough to render such other country the country of origin. Also false information, also false statement, because it has to meet tariff shifting requirement. In other words, it has, in the case of our product over here, it has to meet this particular criteria. It has to meet the tariff shifting rule. In United States, it has to change to heading 39 to 3902 from any other heading outside of these headings, right? From any other heading outside of these headings, because it says including another heading within a group, right? Unless it's 3907. Here it's 3902, period. So no change takes place. So B is correct, is not correct. Then, so we eliminated those. This is where customs examiner suggests that part 10220, section 10220 is applicable because they're talking about NAFTA marking rules. So whenever you see here NAFTA marking rules, think part 102. The NAFTA marking rules never require that each foreign material incorporated undergoes through tariff classification. We just saw the table. It's all over the chart. So D is not correct. Then I think we skipped over C. C, the NAFTA marking rules are never used to determine the country origin for NAFTA. No, we saw in a general note 12 that NAFTA marking is in part a requirement for determining the proper country, the qualification of that product for NAFTA preferential duty. So C is not correct. So E is the only one left, right? So let's take a look what it says. The NAFTA marking rules require a change to heading 3901 through 3915 from any other heading, including another heading from within that group. The required tariff heading change does not occur, therefore the country of origin of the product remains the France. All right, so this is the quotation from that particular section that we saw, including any other heading, including another heading from that group. So this is pretty much copy and paste provision. The second one, the required tariff heading change does not occur, therefore country of origin of the product remains France, is the application of that rule. True, the HTSUS number remained the same. True, NAFTA tariff shift did not take place. True, country of origin for the product for marking purposes, for NAFTA marking purposes, remains France. So E is the correct answer.